Guys, our Egungu have enter express. Egungu have enter express. We have motor of jamos. Motor of jamos, guys. I cannot deal. Pray for me. Egungu, she have enter what? Express. Serious, now guys, welcome back to my channel. But before I get into the gist of today and give you guys an update of what's going on, I want you guys to help me thank God today. Specifically, today is 1st of May, and we came into the month with so much joy and as much as anticipation, just hopeful for a better month and for a better year and all of that. So thank God on all of those things. But today we had a fire outbreak in my house, in our kitchen. It was a situation, but with me, the kind of person that I am, I usually don't panic when things like that happen. It doesn't matter what's going on. I don't fear a lot. I don't panic as much. So yeah, there was a fire outbreak. Yes, our kitchen was on fire. Stove caught fire. There was fire on the ground. There was fire like flying around. But we managed to pour water. We have a lot of buckets of water close to the kitchen. So we just kept on pouring until the fire went out. So yeah, that's my testimony. So you guys should help me thank God for saving my family and I from a fire outbreak. It's a big deal. I don't take it for granted at all. As in, I don't, because I know little things like that is what has consumed people's houses, and things like that have ruined people's lives. But I just want to thank God that even though there was a scare this morning from the devil, he tried it, you know? But yeah, God delivered us. And the funny part is our gas was just close to the stove. Our gas and our stove, they're very close, but thankfully the gas wasn't on. Our gas was sealed, and I don't know what happened, but it didn't catch fire, even though there was fire on the ground and this gas cylinder was next to the fire. But yeah, none of them, nothing bad happened. So it was just the fire from the stove and the ones on the ground, and when we poured water, everything went out and we were fine. So praise the Lord, hallelujah. So yeah, that's, by the way, the Bayelsa state, my state, it have what? It have express. It have enter what again? Express. Our Egungu shall enter express. So we woke up this morning to 4 extra cases of the COVID corona. Now we have 5 cases of corona in Bayelsa state. That's what they said, 5 cases. Like, are you guys understanding what I'm saying, that the cases are actually increasing in my state? We went from 0 cases to 1 case last week to on Sunday, 1 case, yes, this week Sunday, and today is what, Friday, and we have 5 cases. Okay, so yeah, there's that. I just want to tell you guys that our cases have increased from 1 to 5 right now. And I don't know, but the national whole lockdown thing is supposed to end on the 4th. Even the one my state governor increased is a 1 week lockdown. After 1 week lockdown, we don't know if it's going to increase this lockdown for another how many weeks. We do not know. Right now, I'm personally tired of staying at home. I want to go back to work. But anti-corona is in town, so I don't know if I really want to go to work. As in, like, I don't know. No, I'm not scared, but I'm very careful. And now, with me personally, I don't go out with all this situation. Since I've not been going to work, I've been at home. But I've been learning how to drive. You guys already know that, right? I'm learning how to drive. I'll do my driving lessons video for another video, but I just want to let you guys know I'm learning how to drive, and my uncle is the one teaching me. So my uncle, my mom's younger brother, by the way, my uncle is a pharmacist, so he's an health worker, he's an health official. He's a health worker, he's a health official. So he goes around with people, he touches people, he gets in contact with sick people. And right now, because of the, I don't know the number of tests that have been done in Bayelsa, I don't even think it's that high. So we can't even ascertain the number of people that have coronavirus. And because my uncle is in contact with sick people, I kind of feel unsafe. That's my major concern with all of this. Because as much as I don't go out, I enter my uncle's car and then I drive to wherever until we are done and then we come back. So that's because I'm in such close contact with someone that deals with sick people at this point, I don't feel so safe. I try to wash my hands and sanitize. I'm trying the best I can to be safe. and these numbers keep increasing. And the worst part of this whole Bayelsa situation is that people are not taking this thing seriously. Even with the lockdown, it's like our lockdown is audio. I don't know what's going on. People are not in their houses. People are on the streets. People everywhere. Like, there's keke moving. I don't get it. There's that. Okay, so I told you guys the last time that our governor eased the lockdown for, it's from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. I thought it was just for one day, but apparently it's for the whole 1 week lockdown. That the lockdown for every, even, what kind of lockdown is that? You tell me. So we have a 1 week lockdown in. But for the 1 week, every day from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m., people can move around to buy things and just chill. And then from 1 p.m., police starts arresting people. Is that how your own lockdown is working in your state? Because my own state, like I said, is no, I don't get it. So yeah, I think my friend was like, I told my friend that he could move. He was going to get something done. So I told him, okay, you can move. Because if you're driving personal cars, apparently you can move. So I told him that he could move from 8 a.m. to 1 p.m. So yesterday when he was driving, time was about like past 1. The police held his car. They stopped him and he was not supposed to be driving after 1 o'clock. So I don't know how he maneuvered and got out of the police. But yeah, he came. I had to give him something. And then, yeah. So yeah, they're arresting people after 1 o'clock. And I will have curfew. I think what Bayelsa has understand is curfew. If it's curfew by 7 p.m., you'll not see anybody. Usually, but like I said, Bayelsa and Yenagoa is a very slow, easy breezy. So normally, we don't even keep late nights. It's not even the safest city in Nigeria. So we try as much as possible to get home early. So if you say 7 p.m. curfew, everybody's home by 7 p.m. Normal. Like, there's no traffic. There's no anything. So we get home quite early enough in the day. So curfew, people quite understand curfew. But this whole lockdown today, people have refused to stay in their houses. People do not understand lockdown. So I feel like the governor should just say there's curfew from 6 a.m. to 6 a.m. the next day. If he says there's curfew from, say, okay, for example, if he says 6 a.m. to 11 p.m. Yeah. No, they say there's curfew from 11 p.m. till, how am I going to say this? If they say there's curfew from 7 p.m. to, say, 3 p.m. the next day, like dusk to dawn, no, but it's 7 p.m. till the next 5 p.m. something like that. People understand curfew. People don't understand lockdown, but they understand curfew in Bayelsa State. That's what I've come to understand. So yeah, we have that. We are battling with people adhering to this whole government lockdown situation, and now that our cases are increasing, I don't know what's going to happen, if they're going to extend the lockdown, or if we are going to go back to work after beginning May 4th. I don't know what all of this. I don't know how all of this is going to pan out. But yeah, you guys should pray for us. I mean, everybody's praying for everybody, but pray for us. Pray for Bayelsa as you're praying for your state. Please remember Bayelsa in your prayers, and remember me specifically, because like I said, I'm working with a pharmacist learning how to drive, and yeah, pray for my uncle to be safe. Obviously he has to go to work, he's a health official. And yeah, also my younger sister works in a hospital in America, and we know the situation in America, and I mean, it's quite bad. So pray for all of us, love yourself, pray for your family. Guys, I'm just tired at this point. But anyways, that's what I have for you guys today. Please stay safe, guys. Wash your hands. So stay in your houses. So please, I beg you. Go out only when it's absolutely necessary. I beg, yeah? Sanitize. Use face mask. Please. Eh? I want everybody to be safe and to be happy, healthy. Yeah, we're watching my YouTube videos. Yeah? Yeah, thanks for watching, guys. Until I see my next video, please remain in God. God bless you. Bye.